are tons of videos out there teaching the unique groove from Toto's song Rosanna, here's how you nail the drum sound of this famous tune. After Toto released Rosanna in 1982, it soon became a worldwide hit. For this tune, Jeff Porcaro created one of the most famous drum grooves of all time, known as the Rosannashuffle. Besides the groove itself, Toto also nailed the overall sound of this record. Now let's make a modern Sonor ProLite kit sound exactly like Porcaro's original Rosanna drum set. First, we installed a reso head with a huge hole on the 22-inch bass drum to get a short and controlled sound. For the right attack, we used a coated single-ply Remo Ambassador drum head and added some muffling. This is what we ended up with. But the bass drum itself doesn't really define the drum sound. Let's move on to the most important drum in the setup, the snare drum. The Sonor 14x6.5-inch cottonwood artist snare features a nice attack paired with a lot of body, which worked great here. To reduce the snare's ringy overtones, we went with a pre-damped and coated Remo Power Stroke 3 drum head. We taped a paper handkerchief on the batter head to get even closer to the characteristic muffled 80s drum sound. This common trick was already used 40 years ago. Besides the famous shuffle groove, Rosanna also features great fill-ins. We decided to go with four toms to complete our shell setup. The length of the snare and toms is created by adding reverb in post-production. So when preparing the toms, we concentrated on creating a nice attack and short controlled overtones. Our go-to drum head combination for this sound is a clear double-ply Remo Emperor as batter and a clear single-ply Remo Ambassador as the bottom head. The Remo Emperor heads have great attack and also feature nice overtones. To control these, we used the handkerchief muffling on the toms as well. The bigger the drum, the more muffling was needed. To reduce the sustain of the drums, we tuned the reso head slightly higher than the batter heads. This is our tom sound without reverb. Now that all drums are prepared, it's time to get the kit together. The Zildjian New Beat hi-hat we used features a nice attack without having too many overtones. The cymbal setup is completed by three crashes and a riot from Zildjian's A and K series. Before we add the characteristic 80s reverb, let's listen to the kit as it is. Sounds good, but here's the real deal. Let's bring in the music. Amazing how close this is to the sound of the original. Now go ahead and use these sound ideas for your own setup. Be sure to let us know what you think about our Rosanna kit, and subscribe to our channel for more videos every week.